kids. I miss you so much. And one of the things I miss about our class is hearing you all sing. But you can sing at home for your families. I'm sure they'll love it. And you can teach them the songs too. So let's sing some of our songs I hope you remember from school. Let's start with My God Is So Great. You ready? We start a little bit quiet and then we get loud and we shout for great. Okay, because God is so great, He made the whole world, everything. One, two, three. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are His, the rivers are His, the stars are His handiwork too. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do for you. Good job. All right. Let's sing another song that maybe you remember. God is good to me. Because no matter what happens, God is always good. He loves you very much. Ready? Let's sing it in our beautiful voices first. God is good to me. God is good to me. He holds my hand. He helps me stand. God is good to me. Good job. And let's sing it. Should we sing it super, super fast? If you remember it, let's sing it super fast. God is good to me. God is good to me. He holds my hand. He helps me stand. God is good to me. That was pretty fast. And what's the opposite of super, super fast? The opposite of fast is slowly. That's right. So let's sing it slowly. God is good to me. God is good to me. He holds my hand. He helps me stand. God is good to me. Okay. Good job remembering our old songs and keep singing them. All right. So our month is the month of May. And let's do our days of the week really fast. Days of the week. 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 There's Sunday and there's Monday. There's Tuesday and there's Wednesday. There's Thursday and there's Friday. And then there's Saturday. Days of the week. 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 Okay, so today is Wednesday. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. And we have a lot of numbers to count, so count them together with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Today is Wednesday, May 13. Say it together with me. Today is Wednesday, May 13. Good job. And today I have a special story to you, for you, for Mother's Day. It's a Mother's Day story. And Mother's Day was last Sunday, the holiday where we remember our mothers and show them that we love them and think about how special they are. So today's Mother's Day story is called the Mother's Day mice. Biggest little mouse wakened first. It was early morning and still almost dark. He tugged gently on the whiskers of Middle Mouse, who slept next to him. "It's Mother's Day," he whispered. "Time to get up and go for our presents." Middle Mouse tugged gently on the whiskers of Little Mouse, who slept between him and the wall. "Mother's Day," he whispered. They crept out of bed and tiptoed past Mother's room. Outside, one star still slept in the sky. They stopped to wash paws and faces in the pail of water Mother kept by the front door. Biggest studied his watch. "We have 2 hours before Mother wakes up. Middle and I know what we're getting for her and where to find it." He looked at Little Mouse and waited. "I know what I'm getting too," Little Mouse said. "Honeysuckle." Biggest shook his head. "Little Mouse, honeysuckle only grows on Honeysuckle Cottage, and we know who lives in Honeysuckle Cottage. You'll have to find something else for Mother. Honeysuckle is a kind of flower." Little Mouse wanted to argue, but Biggest was already lining them up, one behind the other. "Hold tails and be quiet as we go," he said. "The dark has dangers for little mice." They ran across the meadow. Little Mouse liked the tough, smooth feel of his brother's tail. He thought that the three of them joined together must be as long as a snake. He didn't want to think about snakes, though, because snakes eat mice. Ooh. The edges of sky were streaked with morning. A red fox passed them on his way home. They crouched till the white tip of his tail disappeared in the trees. "Grrr," said Little Mouse fiercely. "Who's afraid of him?" But his voice was so weak that he couldn't hear it himself. An owl sheered above them as they lay hidden in the long grass. Little Mouse kept his eyes tightly closed. If he couldn't see the owl couldn't see him. That's what he thought. "You didn't have to squeeze my tail so hard," Middle Mouse told him when they stood up. "I thought you might be frightened," Little Mouse said. "I was telling you I was here," Middle Mouse sniffed. A strawberry patch grew at the edge of the meadow. "There's my surprise for Mother," Middle Mouse said. "She loves strawberries. She says the first ones taste of summer coming." Biggest Mouse boosted him so he could get the roundest, reddest berry from the top. Its weight tipped him backward as he carried it. "My surprise is here too," Biggest Mouse said. He picked a dandelion fluffball and held it high by its milky stem. "It's a wish flower for Mother." Little Mouse thought about the fluffball was as beautiful as a spinning of spider's webs. He could see the sky through it. "Mother will love it," Mouse said. "Now can we go for the honeysuckle? We have time, and maybe he won't be there." Biggest Mouse sighed. "We'll go look, but only because you're the littlest and it's Mother's Day. And we won't get close. Cat is always there." Cat was there. He lay on the porch of Honeysuckle Cottage, monstrously big, monstrously black. When he yawned, his mouth was a dark spiked cave. Little Mouse could see it clearly, even though they weren't too close. "Maybe he'll leave soon," Little Mouse whispered. He pulled his eyes away from Cat to the honeysuckle that twined around the porch. Honeysuckle from Mother. They're hiding in the grass. Inside the cottage, someone was playing a piano. The tune was "Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star." Dum dee dum dee dum dee da, dum dee dum dee dum dee da. "Maybe Cat likes to lie in the sun and listen to music," Little Mouse whispered. Maybe the person will stop playing soon and Cat will go away. He sniffed the honeysuckle air and pretended not to see Biggest Mouth checking the time. Dum-dee-dum-dee-dum-dee-da. That person is not going to stop playing piano, Middle muttered. He set his strawberry on the ground and a beetle came on the run. Middle picked it up again and shooed the beetle away. Little Mouse began creeping toward the cottage on his belly. Biggest yanked him back by his tail. Stop that! Anyway, it's time to go. What if Mother wakes up on Mother's Day and all her little mice are missing? Or eaten, Middle said. We have to go, Biggest said. I'm sorry, Little Mouse. But inside Little Mouse's head, something had started to beat. Something wonderful that was the beginning of an idea. Something better than honeysuckle. It's all right, Little Mouse said. The sun made a pink path across the meadow as they ran for home. Bring her a daisy, Biggest said over his shoulder. She likes daisies. Bring her a rock, Middle puffed. A small rock that's not hard to carry. They're nice, Little Mouse said, but they're not special enough for this special day. He had something special, though. He had it strong and firm in his mind when they got home. Little frog. Biggest took the fluff ball in a jar beside Mother's chair. Middle put the strawberry in a blue dish on the table. I'm glad I didn't roll it, he said. Sometimes I wanted to, but I carried it all the way, and it isn't even squished. He glanced sideways at Little Mouse. The strawberry can be free from you too, Little Mouse. Aw. And the fluff ball will be from both of us, Biggest said. Little Mouse smiled. Thank you, but I brought something of my own. He thought it was funny when his brothers looked all around and then rolled their eyes at each other. Something I kept hidden, he said. Biggest Mouse held up a warning paw. Shh, Mother's coming. Happy Mother's Day, they all shouted when she came in the kitchen. And Mother said, why, you remembered. Remembered, we almost got eaten three, Middle began, but Biggest poked him hard. Sometimes Middle talked too much. Mother blew all the fluff ball, and it exploded into a million beautiful feathery seeds. Did you make a wish? Biggest asked. Yes, a wonderful wish. Mother cut the strawberry in four pieces. I love strawberries, she said. The first one's taste of summer coming. She nibbled on the edge of berry and closed her eyes, and Little Mouse knew she was tasting sunshine and sweet corn and the cold waters of meadow stream. Now me, he said. He was so excited, he thought he might explode like the fluff ball into a million pieces. The music he'd heard at Honeysuckle Cottage was loud in his mind, and he clasped his paws and began to sing. He sang the words he'd thought of as they ran home. We have brought a song to say, happy, happy Mother's Day. No one's mother is so nice, love from all your little mice. We have brought a song to say, happy, happy Mother's Day. That was wonderful, Mother said when he finished. How astonished his brothers were. They'd thought he had nothing, and all the time he'd had this. Was it better than honeysuckle? Little Mouse asked. Much better, Mother said. Honeysuckle doesn't last forever. A song does. Was it the best of all your surprises? As soon as he asked that, Little Mouse felt mean. The song is from all of us, he said quickly. Mother smiled. All my surprises were lovely. You each brought me something different, and you each brought me something the same. Do you know what that was, Little Mouse? Little Mouse knew. They brought her their love. Mother opened her arms wide and they ran to her. Let's sing Little Mouse's song, she said. So they did. Mother and her three little mice swayed together as they sang, and the kitchen was warm with wishes and summer coming, music and love. That's the end of our Mother's Day story. Make sure you tell your mom that you love her and that she's special.